The third point you had talked about in your source code of storytelling was doing a backwards editorial pass. So talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite things to do. And that's one of those things where, I always say it, I keep on saying it. Nothing I say is a rule, but this is one of those things that I say to people. And I think it's resonated for a lot of people that I've shared it with, is that I always edit my books backwards at least once. Usually as I'm nearing the end, when I know that I'm almost done, I will go in and I'll start with the last chapter and then just start working my way forward to the beginning. And it does a couple of things. It helps to see the book out of order, because sometimes you might clock things about the flow or the narrative structure that weren't really working. But more importantly, what I think it does is it infuses a lot of fresh energy into the ending. Because my experience as a freelance editor has been that people have given me books that I see so much time and so much effort has gone into the beginning of the story. And then you can tell by the end, they were just like, I just want to be done. I am finished. You know, and things kind of peter out and you lose some of that energy. You get that, like, I want to be done energy. And I think taking that sort of like beginning energy and really letting it sit in the ending is something that could be really useful. And it's always useful for me, because I always, whenever I do it, I sit there with my last chapter and I'm like, man, like looking at it just out of sequence with a fresh set of eyes, I was like, yeah, I get it. This is not working. And this is why. It's because I want it to be done.
Have you ever written the last chapter first?
Oh, God, no. I very much write in linear sequence, and that's the best way for me that it works. I always know mostly what my ending is going to be, if not in specifics, then at least in spirit. You know, I don't know that I could ever write a story without understanding where I was going, because if I was just sort of like writing, then I would write forever and would never stop. But yeah, it's usually my endings, I feel like, are pretty close to where they always are going to end up being.
You talked about sometimes the energy has become, I just want to get this done energy. Are there red flags you look out for when you're reading that ending, or tips you have for people if they try this out and they experience that, but they don't know how to fix it?
That's a good question. You know, I always try to take each section that I'm working on, whether it be a chapter or like a larger section of the book, and try to view it like completely in sort of, how do I say this? Like its own little islands. You know, I'm still considering the rest of the story and how it plays out, but I'm most focused on what is this one particular scene mean? What needs to happen here? Am I accomplishing that? Am I getting across the point that I want to make? Are the characters doing what they need to do? It's isolation. It's trying to view these things in isolation, almost. Almost like you would consider an episodic season of television, where, you know, you've got an episode that tells that keys into a broader story, but is still telling a very specific narrative that's confined to 30 to 45 minutes or whatever. And when I think of it in terms like that, it's easier to kind of look at that and say, okay, the only thing that matters right now is this scene, these two characters in this cafe having this conversation. Am I accomplishing what I set out to accomplish when I put it here in the first place?